All right, we're back in the studio. Wow, that was an exhausting trip. I don't know about all of you, but I'm still catching up on sleep, and I've been trying my hardest to get caught up. My lips have healed, they're no longer chapped, so that's good. Let's jump into the biggest workspace-focused updates from Google next. First off, if you haven't followed any of the news, there's a new app for Google Workspace. It's called Vids, and it joins the ranks of the illustrious Docs, Sheets, Slides, now Vids.
I'm absolutely thrilled to announce our newest Workspace app, Google Vids. Sitting alongside Google Docs, Sheets, Slides, Google Vids is an AI-powered video creation app for work.
This is a huge deal. I don't know how they managed to keep it a secret from everybody. Google is an incredibly leaky company normally. Turns out, they do know how to keep a secret, because this one didn't really come out. I was able to do a little bit of digging, and it turns out this comes from the previously known Area 120 app called Threadit, which was where you could send videos to folks as part of a conversation, where each reply was another leg in the conversation. When Area 120 closed, that team was dissolved and very quickly moved over to another area in the company, but we never really found out where. Now we know. It's going to have deep-level Gemini integration. It basically looks like the interface of Slides, but applied to video. Instead of having your slides on the sidebar, you instead have a timeline along the bottom. You're going to be able to work from templates, start your own custom video, or even prompt Gemini to start a rough draft for you. We're told it's going to be able to auto-edit the ums out of your videos, but I don't know if that's going to be something that it's going to auto-edit the video itself, or if that is just going to be in the transcript. I will dig into that and let you know. It's a lot of information here, so I'll link to the articles down below so that you can catch up on all of the juicy details. The last thing I will say is that it is going to be rolling out to labs in June, so stay tuned for more. Next up, we have two new AI workspace add-ons. You have the AI meetings and messaging add-on, which gives you the ability to auto-translate captions in Meet, also includes Take Notes for Me, Studio Sound, and Studio Lighting, and that's $10 monthly. The other add-on announced is the AI security add-on. This will allow you to auto-classify and protect sensitive files. It enables experimental post-quantum cryptography. I didn't even realize that was a thing at this point. And both of them are going to be available for $10 monthly. Now, one point of clarification on there is that if you already pay for Gemini Business, you will need one of these if you want those specific features. But if you pay for Gemini Enterprise, as many of you already do, all of the features just mentioned are going to be included. Now, real quick, I'm going to throw it back to myself on the show floor for a word about our sponsor. Real quick, I want to introduce you to an important partner of the Google Workspace ecosystem. Over my shoulder, you can see the logo here is Jamf. We've talked about them on the show before, and I have a special guest, Michael Covington, VP of Strategy. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
Real quick, for those who aren't familiar with Jamf, why don't you tell us a little bit about the company?
Sure thing. We are an endpoint security and device management company that has a special focus on the Apple ecosystem. And you might be wondering, what is a device-centric company doing at a cloud event? And I can tell you, all users, no matter what device they're choosing to get work done on, they need the productivity suite, and Google Workspace is a great place for a lot of people to do their work. Jamf helps deploy those applications, helps connect the workers to the tools that make them productive at work, and we add a security layer on top as well whenever they're using an Apple device.
Fantastic. We're big fans of Google Workspace here for anybody who has watched the show before. All right, give us a quick tour of the booth. Pretend we just walked up here. Walk us through what's going on. What do you want people to take away from Google Next?
I think the most important takeaway here at a cloud event is that no matter what device a user is picking up, that device is the gateway into the cloud infrastructure for them. And so what we're here to do is actually make sure that that device, whether it's a personal device or a company-issued device, is ready for work. It's got the tools that are necessary. It's got the visibility for the business to make sure that it's assessed and compliant and meeting the company standards, and that the user has the applications that they need to actually get connected and be productive at work.
Amazing. Well, stay tuned for more information, Jamf.com, right? Folks should go and check it out.
Jamf.com/integration/Google if you want to actually get right down into the specific details on what we've done in partnership with Google here.
Perfect. Thanks for having me. Thanks for making it possible for us to come out and do this type of content. And now back to the video. Real quick, some more information on some of the features we haven't seen before, such as Take Notes for Me.
Keep up with notes and action items. Instead of engaging in a really important meeting, now Gemini can join the meeting and be a world-class note taker for everyone.
I did get a chance to play with it in labs, and I didn't have the most success with it, but I did speak to the team while I was at Next, and they're continuing to tweak, and that's what labs is for. It is very early beta, and they are taking my use case into account and making sure that the results come back are what are desired. Ideally, though, this is going to be a complete game changer. Instead of me hammering away at the keyboard during a meeting, hardly able to participate as I furiously take notes to make sure I don't miss anything, I'm going to instead be able to flip the script, turn around, and actually participate in the meeting, possibly even speak in the meeting, and not have to worry about missing anything because it will take notes for us. And from what I have seen, it does work quite well. It just doesn't do everything as accurate as I would like to, and that's what they're still tweaking. As mentioned, also included in the AI meetings and messaging add-on are studio sound and studio lighting, which if you have already been using a previously Duet, now Gemini Enterprise license, you will have experience with, but enables you to have even better sound improvement, noise canceling, etc., as well as different features for doing your lighting and changing your appearance and different backgrounds that you can create. All will be available in the AI meetings and messaging add-on. I did get a demo of the auto AI classification happening in Google Drive as part of the AI security add-on and Enterprise Gemini Enterprise license, and I have to tell you, it was honestly mind-blowing. The person doing the demo took a document that had PII, personally identifiable information, in it, and created a new document. He copied information from the original document and pasted it in the new document, and within seconds, the new document was classified and locked down and would not enable him to share it out to other people that were not allowed to be shared with outside of his group or his company. This happened in near real time. It took maybe 2 seconds for it to complete, and I will include a video of it here. Moving on, chat got a whole bunch of updates here. Gemini is coming to Google Chat in preview. And another feature that we've long awaited is finally coming to the home screen is threading, which is the ability to view your threads on the home screen, which until now you were not able to do.
Threads in home. When somebody responds in line to a thread, that is going to be available right in home. And the other is the ability to one-click respond to the thread right in home without having to leave it, enabling you to really quickly get through your messages when you start your day or in between meetings.
You're also going to be able to create custom sections and custom labels in Google Chat, which is something that I have wanted since they launched the product years ago. There was an interesting statistic they shared about the number of people who are using Spaces. They said 70% of folks that use Google Chat regularly are also regularly using Spaces. It's something that I recommend. I like the way that they're deployed. And as more companies consolidate their messaging solutions and get rid of things like Slack, I imagine that number is going to continue to rise. A few more topics here. Huddles, which we have been hearing about for, 2 years now, or at least it feels like it, is finally going to be released and is coming to chat. Another feature, which is apparently very highly requested from Latin America, although I personally don't like the way that it's implemented right now, is voice notes are now generally available in Google Chat. This is just like any other application you would use, such as WhatsApp, where you can send a message, which is just a recording of your voice. Now, the reason why I don't like the way that it's implemented is because many times when somebody sends me a message, I'm not in an area where I can listen to it. So if Google were to automatically transcribe those messages, that would be enormously helpful. Google, please get on that. Also rolling out now is a redesigned shared tab, which is going to be an enormous improvement to anybody who uses Spaces on the regular. Anytime you share files in a space, you're going to see those files be listed in the shared tab, and until now, it was just a basic list. Now, as they add more features such as tasks and assignments, you'll be able to see this much more organized in the new shared Spaces area. Lastly, is something that I need to see this rolled out before I have an opinion on it, is a board space, and this is going to be Gemini generated to store messages, files, and links, have AI-powered suggestions, and is apparently kind of like a home base for a project. Remember back in the day when I talked about Google adding more and more project management features, but still not giving us a fully fledged task management system? This plays into that some more, and still we don't have the ability to assign tasks across from inside of documents to tasks to wherever. The two last things I want to mention here is that you're now going to be able to invite guests to your chat group via email, and Google is expanding space capacity all the way up to 500,000 users. Also, you're going to be able to see view counts of how many people saw your chat, which goes along with having that many people in the group, is you actually want to know if you are having a lot of people see your messages. Over on the editor's side, they announced tabs in documents.
New tabs feature in Google Docs. It helps you keep organized with everything that you need to collaborate effectively with your team. I'm going to rename this first tab here, Industry Research. And then I'm going to create a new tab for my marketing plan. So I can just keep everything organized here. Okay.
This is something that I am continuing to call the Notionification of Google Docs, because this is a feature that has been very useful in apps such as Notion over the years, and it is now moving over to Google Docs, which turns your documents, especially in page lists, into more of a knowledge base instead of just a document. It is also the natural evolution of a table of contents. Over on the Gmail side, they were focusing a lot on cybersecurity.
In Gmail, 20% less spam on average is reaching your inbox thanks to large language models. At the scale that we operate, this is a meaningful quality of life improvement for billions of users. Large language models also help our safety teams evaluate more user-reported spam in Gmail than we could before to prevent unwanted email for everyone. This is like having 1,000 times more people fighting against spam on your behalf.
Oh, by the way, you're welcome.
They're also bringing DLP controls and classification labels. That's going to be coming in a beta, so stay tuned for that. And lastly, continuing on the cybersecurity side, for Gmail, they reported that 1 in 3 of the routinely exploited vulnerabilities in 2022 were only on Exchange. Workspace had a grand total of 0. So if you had any question about which service is more secure, now you know. Two other big elements that I found from the conference regarding Gemini is that you're now going to be able to remove backgrounds in Google Slides, which is a game changer feature and something that we have wanted to see for a very long time. So thank you for finally implementing that, Google. And the last one here blew my mind is that right now, Gemini has the ability in the sidebar in Google Drive to ingest an entire folder's worth of documents. So if you have, for example, 100 resumes in a folder in Google Drive, you can tell Gemini, hey, Gemini, take a look at, oh, it didn't set off any of my Google devices. That's good. Take a look at everything in this folder and pick out for me or find me the names of people who went to this school or people who say this term that you're looking for in the resume, such as Gemini or Google Docs or Workspace or something along those lines, so you can easily start to digest and go through which ones you may be interested in looking at first. Overall, this was a mega conference, and I'm very much looking forward to next year. I have another video coming up in a couple of days as soon as I can get that edited, which will be more of a vlog style. So hit the subscribe button if you're new here, and thanks for watching.